IFRS 16 was issued by the International Accounting Standard Board in January 2016 and which will be effective from January 1st, 2019 onwards to all business houses. So IFRS 16 will replace the previous lease standards and interpretations like IAS 17, and the new standard largely impacts on the leases and won't have much influence to the lessors. So the lessees have a significant impact rather than lessors. And if you are talking about the impacts, many positive outcomes are expected out of the introduction to the new leases. The major ones are increase in leased asset and financial liabilities on the balance sheet of the lessees. IFRS 16 doesn't make a distinction between finance leases and operating leases in perspective of lessees. As a result, leases will be treated as finance leases in the books of lessees. And short-term and low-value leases are exempted to treat according to IFRS 16. So you will have to recognize most leases on a balance sheet, whatever your industry you are doing the business. And related to the outputs, if you see that new accounting treatment will lead to an increase in net debt, a higher EBITDA and a higher invested capital for the lessee. Moreover, it leads to increased visibility of all leases, which will help the investors to make a better informed investment decisions. Enhanced economic growth is also a possible through IFRS 16 as it improves the capital allocation. So coming back to IAS 17, IFRS 16 replaces IAS 17, IFRS 4 and SIC 15. Apart from that, it is replacing SIC 27 also. If you look into the complete perspective of IAS 17, IAS 17 was introduced with a substance over form and present value concept, which was never followed till that time. And now if you look into this aspect, it's almost unchanged last 27 years. So the issues what we are facing currently is that IFRS 16 requires companies to bring lease commitments onto their balance sheets, which was not mandatory earlier. For instance, take a look into the listed companies that use IFRS and US GAAP for their reporting that have around 3.3 million of lease commitments. And over 85% of these leases do not appear on the balance sheet. So the reason is till date these leases were categorized as operating leases. That means the readers of financial statements is not getting a real picture about the financial liabilities and leased assets which is used or which is having in the books of these companies. And the assessment part, when lease assets and liabilities are not accounted in the financial statement, it will not give you a clear-cut accounting picture. An estimation of lease liabilities is always a difficult task. If you take a proportion of the actual debt related to the leased liabilities, it comes up to 6 to 10% related to the total liability of the balance sheet of any companies, what we mentioned earlier. With IFRS 16, this problem can be taken to a greater extent. So as a conclusion, we have discussed about the pros of IFRS 16 before now, and it is going to bring more transparency to any business. But how difficult it will be to the companies to comply the new standard, it might be quite challenging. If your company has a well-organized lease administration and accounting functions, then this won't be a difficult process. All you have to do is evaluate whether adjustments are required in the existing systems to accommodate the changes. Understanding the impact of IFRS 16 is vital to your organization. At an early stage, it will enable you to sort out the issues properly and reduce implementation cost and compliance risk.